Welcome everyone to The New Fly Fisher. I'm your host, Bill Spicer. On this week's show, we're in beautiful Labrador on the Hawke River. We're guests of Hawke River Outfitters and our quarry for this week, Atlantic Salmon. We'll talk about the flies, the rods and reels, and the strategies. This is going to be a real technical show, so get your notebooks ready and we'll be right back.
Let him go back to live another day.
And away he goes. Great fish. Wow.
Oh, baby, look at that fish.
Stop, wiggle, on the way down.
The New Fly Fisher has been made possible thanks to Newfoundland and Labrador Outfitters Association, Islander Precision Reels, and Orvis Sporting Traditions.
Hawke River Outfitters is located just outside of Charlottetown, Labrador, approximately 6 kilometers from the mouth of the Hawke River. The float plane ride was about 15 minutes, and the experienced pilot dropped us off at the dock right in front of the camp. The lodge consists of two buildings located right on the river's edge. The camp is run on generators and has a reliable mobile telephone system. Accommodations have showers with hot and cold running water and can accommodate up to 8 anglers. The lodge also provides hearty home-cooked meals, breads, and desserts. The Hawke River is renowned for its prolific numbers of Atlantic salmon, boasting some of the healthiest runs anywhere. The early run of salmon range from 8 to 20 pounds, with heavy later season runs of grills averaging 3 to 6 pounds. Our guide for this trip is Hawke River Outfitters co-owner and head guide, Aster Keynes. For years, Aster has waded the banks of the Hawke River and many of the rivers of the northern peninsula of Newfoundland, where he honed his skills as an angler, guide, and outdoorsman. Aster's knowledge and attitude and attention to detail are second to none. We've just arrived. It's our first day. We're at the first pool here, and Aster, my guide, has said the fish are going to be in this slick, this run coming down and right in, directly in front of me here. I've got a silver blue on, and I've got a hitch on it, or a Portland hitch, or a riffle hitch, whatever you want to call it. And we're going to try to skitter it across the top, and hopefully a fish will rise and take it here. The tactic that I'm using today is we want a wake in the fly, which means the fly comes up to the top and it's actually making a wake. And how you do that when we got slower water like I have right in front of me is we cast out, and as it swings in the current, I start lifting the tip. And what that does, it draws the fly up to the top and you get a proper wake. There we go, fish on. Fish on. Yes, sir. It took a while, but we got it. On wet flies this time. It's a little early in the season for dry flies, I've been told. But I'm fully expecting a big jump here in a second. Oh, yes. This looks like a fairly decent fish. I wouldn't call it large, but it's good. You think it's a second season fish? Yeah, it's second season fish. He's a little bigger than I thought. He's a little bigger than I thought. Yeah, lift him up, and that net will stretch. Yes, sir. Okay, now, that's a good example of what you can get here when you come to Hawke River. These are bigger fish. This is a second season fish. He's probably 10 pounds. I wouldn't fathom to guess any bigger, but good fish. Now I'm gonna put him down and let him revive. He shouldn't take long. And away he goes. Ooh. Huh. That's a start. And it took a little bigger fly. We had a smaller fly on. And we thought, well, let's give them a little more to look at. And that, it took about 5 minutes, but yes, finally took it right down at the end of the run here. Probably as far as I was gonna cast. I don't think I was gonna cast any farther than that. So I'm gonna recheck my knot and see if it needs to be retied, which I probably will.
Animal-wise, you can see caribou, moose, black bear. We've seen all three of those animals, and osprey, eagles, pretty much fish hawks, everything that is looking for a fish.
Well, it's after supper on the first day. We've had a change in weather, as you can see. We've had a front come in, and we got a little bit of rain. Generally, that helps when you're Atlantic salmon fishing. Hopefully we'll get enough rain overnight to raise up the river a little bit and get a fresh run in. So hopefully I can take one tonight. There, I got him that time. Yes, sir, it's good fish. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Ah, yes, big head shakes. Big head shakes, yes, sir.
Nice fish. All we can do
to
eat is the main thing, you know what?
Oh, yeah.
You know what?
Oh, he's going for a run now. And he's...
Woohoo! And that's a good one.
And that was a, that was a different...
That was a different
fish. A different fish, because he was in a different spot.
Yeah. He's a bright one, too. Don't worry.
Oh, good fish, yes. Oh, yes.
Oh, man.
Lots of jumps.
Oh. Let go, let go.
Oh, now I'm in my backing.
Don't try to stop.
Oh, and he let go.
There he's gone.
He let go.
Oh, man.
Well, the fish won that time. And that's what happens a lot with Atlantic salmon fishing. They're so powerful, they leap. I'm gonna see if I still got my fly, but I think possibly he just spit it. Oh, wow. The equipment needed for Atlantic salmon when coming to the Hawke River are 9-foot stiff action rods in sizes 7 and 8 with large arbor reels that have smooth drags. Regulations dictate that only floating lines may be used and that you may not add weight to your leader or to the fly. Two absolute other necessities you need when coming to Labrador are polarized sunglasses. The water here is dark to begin with, and to see the bottom is very tough. And when if you don't have polarized sunglasses, you can't see the bottom. And it is quite treacherous, some of the wading around here. So the other thing that you need is your third leg, your wading staff. This is a necessity too, especially if you've got any problems walking or foot problems or leg problems. That third leg really helps, especially when with some of the larger boulders, you're gonna have to step over them, and it makes it much easier. Well, it's the morning of day 2, and we had a good rain last night, and usually that brings in fresh runs of salmon, so hopefully that happened this morning. We're at a different pool, and I'm liking this a lot because it's a whole lot easier wading for me. I got a bit of a sore knee right now, and this is gonna be good for me today, but hopefully the fish are here, and I'm gonna give it a try. There we go, yes, sir. He jumped right at it, didn't he? All right. Well, I guess what happened is what we were hoping to happen. We got a fresh run of salmon in. And this fella, good job. All right. Well, you know the places. And this, whoa, what, oh, anchor. Anchor rope. He's underneath the boat. Okay. Oh, we got lucky there. Fish went under the boat. Good man. That is fantastic. Okay. Now, he's a skinny one, it's a grilse. Which means that's a first year fish.
He's pretty long, pretty skinny, and he fought well. He fought well. Okay, let's get him back in the water. There he goes. Oh, that was fantastic. Now, we've only been here 20, 25 minutes, and that's my first fish. That's pretty good for salmon fishing. So I'm gonna get back up and back where I was in the hole and start working my way back down again.
Perhaps the most effective way to become a successful angler is to know your tactics and technique. It's often said that 90% of the fish are caught by 10% of the fishermen. Why do these anglers catch most of the fish? It's due to focus. They completely concentrate and immerse themselves in controlling their drift and what their fly is doing. When anglers are constantly distracted, this is when a fish will strike and an opportunity is lost.
And another grouse. Okay, again, I'm gonna try to gain control of him. But this guy's fresh, so he's gonna dictate right now what he wants to do. And I have my trusty wading staff. Oh, the third leg really helps. Get over here in proper water that I can fight this fish properly. Oh, okay. Oh, yes. Oh, spectacular jumps. Good man. Okay, another grouse. And if you look on top, right behind his dorsal fin, there's a sea lice there. Okay, great, nice grouse. I'm having a ball with these grouse. I'm having an excellent morning. I'll catch these all day. I'm perfectly fine with this. Rub his belly a bit. This guy won't be long. Come on, kick. Kick again. Kick. And away he goes. That was tremendous. I'm telling you, I'm having a ball. We're having an excellent morning. We had rain last night, and that always seems to bring in a fresh run of salmon. It raises the level of the water up, and they seem to want to run then. Oh, that's great. Oh, wow.
The season starts around the 24th, 25th of June, and runs through to about mid-August. And they get a good healthy run of big fish from the first 2 weeks until about the 10th of July. And then, well, we get a continuous good run of fish up until about the later part of July, 1st of August. And then it's always a good number of fish in the river.
Some terminology differences that you're going to run into with your guides when coming to Newfoundland and Labrador are a steady. A steady is a slow-moving pool of steady current. Rips. Rips are actually current seams. Where two different currents meet, they call it a rip. The tides. The tides are just the speed of the water. They'll say you don't have a whole lot of tide here, which means your water speed is slow. Or they'll say you have lots of tide here, which means your water speed is high. And their pools are actually what we would call runs, with all different speeds of water, seams in them, they call them pools. So if those are the differences in the terminology, but the main thing is, if you listen to your guide, you're gonna have great fishing.
Right there. Yes, sir. I was just saying, we're just getting into his wheelhouse there. Okay, see if this is a salmon or a grouse. It's a salmon. Yeah, it looks like a fairly good sized fish. Oh, yes. Yeah. Yeah, I got a good jump. The bigger fish don't jump as much as... That is a good fish. Yeah. Okay, just about into my backing now. Now, when they go this far, you got to keep your line up high. Trying to steer them away from that rock over there, because they will try to rub their face on rocks to try to get the hook out. Yeah, he's giving me a good battle. Oh, he's running towards me. Large arbor reels are good. You can wind in the line faster. It's taking all of my 8 weight here to battle him. I'd actually feel a little more comfortable if I had a 9 weight. Good man, good man. Success.
Great fish.
This was a hardy fought fish, that's for sure. That's my best fish of the week. Oh yes, 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 this is what it's all about, folks. This is what it's all about. Now, I don't want to keep him under the water too long. Oh, he's about ready to go. He's fighting a little bit there. I'm gonna give him a little more, make sure he gets there. There he goes. And away he goes. That was the best fish of the week, wasn't it? And he called it. He said he'd come up, shorten up the line. Now, this is what we're talking about, strategies. I shortened up the line and went back at him 6 inches at a time so that he's used to seeing it. And then you're trying to aggravate him. And sure enough, just as I said, I should be in his wheelhouse, he came up and took it. Great strategies, great strategies.
A good selection of flies to bring with you when visiting the Hawke River would be Green Highlanders, Blue Charms, Thunder and Lightning, and Silver Blue. Don't forget to bring a supply of dry flies, which will include Orange Bombers and the Green Machine. One item I want to talk about that you don't want to bring to Labrador are studded boots. Now, we have granite boulders around here, and when walking with studded boots, you're gonna be like walking on an ice rink. So what you wanna bring are felt soles or the new rubber gripper soles that they have out in the market right now. You do not want studded boots. The setup used on this trip is dictated by regulations to be a floating line only, to a 9-foot leader, to a 3X tippet, to the barbless fly. No weight of any kind may be used in or on the system.
There we go. Another salmon, too, I'm pretty sure of it. The way he hit it, the way he hit it was another salmon. Yeah, and the way he's staying down tells me it's a salmon. It's a, just the way it hit, the line just stopped. We've been seeing them swirl at the top, but this time the line just stopped and he was gone. And oh man, what a fish. So I'm gonna try to lead them over like walking the dog. They generally come over if you give them a little side pressure. And I have a very large rock right in front of me. I gotta try to get around it. Oh my. Yeah. Woo-wee. There we go. I think we're cooking with gas. Oh my God. Oh, my arm is tired, folks. My arm is tired. Okay, folks. There he is there. That's what it's all about. Oh my goodness, this is a huge fish. Huge. I won't even say, but look at how thick he is across the back. Look at how thick he is across the back. Okay, I gotta get his face in the water. Calm him down. Yep. And away he goes. I'm excited. I'm actually shaking. That was a terrific fish. Now the hit was a little different on this one. We've been used to them come up and swirling. That one had just stopped dead, like a dead weight. And when I set the hook, I knew I had a big fish. And the big fish tend to stay down right away. And they, as they get closer, then they jump. And then you get the thrill of your lifetime when you see them that big jumping and moving that much water.
Hawke River Outfitters is undoubtedly one of the best Atlantic salmon locations in North America. Awesome beauty, great service, and great people. My stay with them has been nothing short of outstanding, and I highly recommend them.
Well, it's good fish. This is definitely a second winter fish, they're called, which means it's come back to spawn for the second time. They're usually in the 10 to 15 pound area. This one's probably 10 or 12 pounds. Wow. Every time a fish jumps, it takes in air into its gills, which weakens it. So a jumping fish isn't such a bad thing. But this guy is gonna go downstream on me. I can't stop him, now I gotta move. Keeping him up. All right. Now, this is what it's all about.
He's a dandy fish.
That's a dandy fish, in anybody's mind. It's a dandy, dandy fish. He's quivering there, but, oh, wowee. This is the thrill for me when I get a fish like this that I can do that to and allow him to leave. That is what it's all about. Now, the one thing I've learned on this trip is patience. Astor has told us to systematically take apart a pool 6 inches at a time, and that was the payoff. For more information on today's show and other shows in our series, visit us on the web at thenewflyfisher.com. From all of us here at The New Fly Fisher, thanks for joining us. Tight lines, and we'll see you next week.